Hi, in the last video, I got too excited about Redux Toolkit and as a result, made a few mistakes that we need to correct before we move on. If we check in the console in the browser, we have some warnings since I repeated myself when declaring the routes. Let's fix that. I also forgot to add the React Toastify CSS and position the toast container at the right place. Let's go back to IDE. We're going to start with the app.jsx file. So in the src folder, app.jsx. So first, after the toast container, we're going to bring in the CSS. So you can say import React. Oh, there's something wrong. This font size, just change it to make things bigger. So let's make this 26. Good, that's better. So we're going to import React, Toastify, distribution, look for react-toastify.css. It's React Toastify.css, that. And then we're going to go to the routes. In the routes folder here, after the header, that's okay. Then the first route, so this is a self-closing tag here. It's not going to take any children, so you close that route. And then we're going to get rid of this closing routes and this. So when you have like one routes there, then you're going to have the children route. What you're going to do here is route the path of properties. Element is the properties page. Okay, that still remains the same. Then we have the routes. Then immediately after the routes, let's bring our toast container. So move it from there. Put it just before the main tag, like that. Then you save that file. So the warning should have gone. Let's go back to the browser. Let's reload this. Now, if you go to properties, let it load up. No warnings in the console, as you can see. Then you go back to home, no warnings. So we're good to go. So next, let's create a 404 not found page. So let's just close. Let's leave app.jsx open. Let's go to components, client src, components. Then let's create a new component here, create new file. We're going to call this not found. .jsx, then create an arrow function component and export, and then we're going to bring in some elements. So you can say from React Bootstrap, we're going to bring in the column, then the container, and then the row, and then from React icons, so from React slash icons slash fa, we're going to bring in the heartbroken. So FA heartbroken. Oh, broken. And FA sad tier. Yeah, I hope that's correct. Then next, let's declare our component. So we're going to have a container. Oh, and type today. So this is container. Then we're going to have a row. And then we're going to have a column. And the column, whoa, column like that. The column is going to have a class name. The class name is going to be text center. And then what next do you want to do? We're going to declare a H1. You can say heading one with a class name of not found, like that. So this is going to have the text of 404, not found. Wow, what's wrong today? Yeah, not found, like that. Then we're going to bring in our icons. So the first one is heartbroken. It's a self-closing tag. Then we're going to have a class name. The class name is going to be broken heart. Then the next icon we're going to bring in is a sad tier. You can say FA sad tier. Then you're going to see the class name here is going to be sad tier. And that's basically it for this component. So the CSS for styling all these class names is we'll find it in the repo in the index.css. As usual, we're not going to write out this CSS in this course. Yeah, you'll get it in the repo. So after this is done, let's wire in the not found page in the app.jsx file. So go back to app.jsx here. Then within this route, we're going to declare another route. And this route for properties page, this is a self-closing tag. It's not going to take any children. We're going to create another route. So this is going to be, let's say, route. Yeah, close that. Then the path is going to be star. then the element here, the element is not going to be the home page. The element is going to be the not found component. I've auto imported it already here, so not found like that. And then for the toast container, let's change the theme. I want it to have a dark theme, so you can say here the theme here is going to be dark. Then save this app.jsx file. Here basically matching to routes that we have not declared up here, redirect that to not found. So if you navigate to a page that doesn't exist, let's go and try this out. Let's say you go to localhost 8080 slash blah blah blah. We are now going to be rendered the not found component. Good. So that is basically it for that. So let's commit our code. So go back to your Git client here, say feature, let's say not found page, then make that commit. With that done, let's now work on the properties page to get our properties displayed. In the property slice, let's amend the case of the fulfilled portion of our X-ray users and make sure that the properties piece of state points to our results, since if you confirm in Insomnia, when you get all properties, the results are in an array. So if you go back to your API client, whatever you used, so if you go to properties, what I'm talking about is this, properties, get all properties. When you make the request, that is on API v1 properties all, you're going to see that our properties are in this array called results. So we need to go and amend our property slice. So let's go back to features here, then property slice, then on extra reducers here where it's fulfilled, we're going to say for the properties a piece of state, it's action.payload.results. That if you don't make this change, the properties are never going to be displayed in the UI. So with that done, let's just go to the backend and confirm something. So if you go to the backend, let's go to the apps, then properties, then serializers. I want to confirm if I serialized the properties well. So the photos, okay. So here, cover photo, photo 1 to 4. These are serializer method fields. They're also included in the fields option here. And then there's a method. Okay, just confirm that your code base resembles this. And then let me also confirm something in the .env file. So that's for the backend. So let's just close all this. So in estate src, go to env and to confirm, yes, API is under allowed hosts and the domain is here, localhost 8080. So I think we are okay. So first things first, so we're going to create a property component in the components directory. So you go back to client here. Then in the components here, let's create a property, new file. This is going to be called property.jsx. Then create an arrow function component. Then we're going to start with the imports as usual. So we can say import from React Bootstrap. We're going to import badge, a button, a card, column and row. Then from React icons, so I say React icons slash font awesome. We want to bring in the bed, FA bed, and FA shower. Then from GI icons, so from React icons slash GA, want to bring in GI stairs. That, oh no, this is supposed to be GI from that icon pack. And then we're going to import link from React Router DOM. So this is a link. And then now we're going to declare the property component. So this component is basically going to display all the attributes for the property. So what you can say that now this property, and another thing is that this property component can be reused in other components. So we're going to pass in a prop. So the prop is going to be property like that. Let's start with this function. So we're going to declare a function which is going to convert our number, because remember properties have a price. So if you go back to the API, just go back here, this price, I want to make it have commas when you are displaying it in the component. So we can say function number with commas, 16x, then basically returns, return x dot first to string. Then we're going to replace and put in the commas using a regular expression. So not going to type this out. I got this from Stack Overflow. Good. Then next, we're going to now return a card. So here we're going to say return a card with a style. So the style here is going to be width. The width is going to be 18 rem, like that. Then the card is going to take in a badge. So we're going to have a badge here. We're going to say the background is going to be success to give it a green color. These are just Bootstrap classes. Then next, we're going to have a class name. So the class name here is going to be position. We're going to position this absolute. Then we're going to say top is 0. Then start at 100. Then we're going to translate in the middle. And then we're going to make it a rounded pill. So all these are just Bootstrap classes. You can check the documentation. Then within the badge, we're going to pass in the property. So where does it... Wow, what am I doing? So all this is supposed to be within the badge here. Then let me see. Yeah, it's supposed to be in the badge there. Then as the child here, we're going to pass in the property. So you can say property. Going to pass in the advert type. So advert underscore type, like that. Then after the badge, we're going to pass in a link. So this link is going to go to, so let's say to, going to go to slash property, then we're going to pass in the property slug. Remember from our API here, each property has a slug. This, good. So pass in the property slug. Then within the link, we're going to add a card. Whoa. So within the link here, we're going to add in a card. We're going to add an image, sorry. So see card.image. We're going to place an image within the card. Then this is a self-closing tag, sorry. Then we can say SSC here, the source is going to be property. Here we want the cover photo. Oh, I can't type today. Okay, property.coverphoto. Cover underscore photo. That. SRC is equals to property.coverphoto. And then I want to pass a variant. So variant is top. Then so something is wrong. Let me see. Property slug. So I have an extra bracket there. Actually, that should be there. So this is link. Import link. Yes, I got it. Let me see. Okay, link to property slash property slug. Yep, that's okay. Then card.image SRC is property.coverphoto. Yes, the variant is top. Aha, I missed that. Wow, what is wrong with me today? Anyway, let's proceed. Then we're going to have a title. So you can say card.title. Then here we're going to put in a class name. So you can say class name here is going to be property price from our CSS. So you can say property price, like that. And then here now for our price, we're going to pass in our function here. We're going to say number with commas because we want our price to have commas at the 1000 mark. Then we're going to pass in number, then format the property price as a number, like that. Then after this, we're going to go to the body. So you can say card.body. Then we can put in the title. So here we can say card.title. Close that. And we're going to format this title as a H4. So you can just say in Bootstrap as H4, like that. And then you're going to pass in the strong tag, like that. And here we're going to pass in property.title. Then after the title, we're going to format the text. So you can say card.text. Yeah, and for the text here, we're going to format this as a paragraph. So you can say as p. Then here we're going to pass in the property description. So you can say property.description. That, then we want the description to only have like a substring of like 70 characters. So you can say substring from 0 to 70. You're going to see how this is going to be formatted. Then you're going to have some ellipses, so three dots, 1, 2, 3, like that. Then after the card text, we're going to pass in a horizontal line, horizontal row like that, HR. Then we're going to have a row. So here we can see row here. So in the row, we're going to take in a column. And in the column, we're going to have some classes. So you can see class name is going to be dflex, because it's using flexbox. Then we're going to justify content, not at the center, but between. And then here is where we want to put in our icons, so you can have span tags. The first span tag we're going to pass in the bed. So FA bed slash like that. Space, then here we're going to pass in property dot bedrooms. Then you're going to pass in another span tag. And here we're going to pass in the shower. You can say FA shower. Oh, what am I doing? FA shower, like that. Then you're going to pass in property dot bathrooms. And then after the span here, we're going to pass, no, we're going to create another span element again. So span, and here we're going to pass in the stairs. So GI stairs, like that. So that is going to go to property dot total floors. Was it total floors? Let me. In our API, we had, yes, total floors. Where are you? Here, total underscore floors. And then go below the row here. We're going to have another horizontal rule. Then we're going to pass in a button. So we can say, so for the button, actually the button is going to be enclosed in a link tag. So you can say here link, and then say here to. So this is going to, if you click the button, you want to go to slash property, you put in backticks, then slash property slash, then bring in the variable of property.slug. So when a person clicks on this button, you go to the slug. So let's put in the button here. So the button is going to be have a variant. The variant is going to be primary. Then here we're going to say get more info. Then you're going to put those greater sign symbols, greater than symbols. So you just say and GT for greater than, semicolon, then ampersand GT, like that. Good, and that's basically it for this property component. So with the properties component done, let's now amend the properties page to bring in our property component. So go back to pages here, then properties page. So one, we're going to bring in, let me see, we're going to bring in Toast from React Toastify. So after the spinner here, we can say from React Toastify, we're going to import Toast. Then, let me see, we need row, column, dispatch, yes, Toast. Then we need to bring in our property component. We can say import from, let's say, property from components slash property. Let me see. Nice. Then let's now go to the actual properties page component. We already have the use selector. We want to bring in our properties. Then is loading. Instead of is success, let's bring in is error. And then the message that goes to state of properties. Good. Then our hook to dispatch the actions as needed. Use dispatch is there. Then use effect. So in our use effect here, we're going to amend it a bit. So you're going to say if there's an error. So if is error is true, we're going to pass the error message as a toast. So you can say toast.error, pass in the message. And then you can pass in an icon if you want. Or if you don't pass in an icon, it's going to use the default icon. So I can just put an emoji. Let me put a crying face. You can put whatever you want. Yeah. Or just leave it empty without this. Then it will use the default icon. So if there isn't an error, if there isn't any error, we're going to dispatch get properties. And then use effect is going to take a dependency. So dependency is dispatch is error and the message. And then if is loading, yes, we're going to pass in the spinner. And then for our container, now we're going to change things here a bit. So here for the row, we can say, for the column here, we want this at the center. So you're going to add a class called text center. Then the H heading one, let's make this, let's say, what do we say here? Let me see. Okay, you can say our catalog of properties, like that. Then we're going to have a horizontal rule here with a class name. The class name is going to be HR text. And then we're going to have our row. So beneath our row here, we want to bring in our property component. So let's put in the brackets for expression. Then we're going to start with our fragment. Then after the fragment, we're going to have a row. We're going to declare a row here. So the row is going to have a class name of margin top 3, MT3, like that. And then within the row, now we want to map through our property, because remember, we're bringing in properties here from the state. So here now, wow, what did I do? Okay, close that tag. Then now we can map through the properties. You can say from our properties, we're going to map through that. And then for each property, for each property here, we're going to pass in this. So let me see. So we're going to pass in a column. So for this column, we're going to, it's going to have a key, because in each iteration you have to have a unique ID. So here we're going to say a key. Here the key is going to be the property dot ID. Let me just confirm that. What was it? There's UUID and yeah. Okay. Yeah. The ID. Then we're going to say for the small screens, take 12 columns. For the medium screens, take in 6. Then for the large screens, take in 4. And for the extra large screens, take in 3. Like that. So in our column here is where we're going to pass in our property component. You can say, bring in the property component here. Then it's going to take in a prop, remember, the property prop. So you can say property is property, like that. And then below the column, actually, there's nothing else below the column. That's just it, because this is the properties list page. So let's save this. Now, if you go to the application, let's go back to our browser here. Then go to properties. Now we're going to get our list of properties displaying here. Then let me see, add puts. Let me see. If you go back to the back end, let me see. Then go to properties. Then was it pagination here? So let's say, let's paginate after 4. Save that. Then refresh. Because in my, yes, in my database, I have like 5 properties. So this is now the display. As you can see, our function here is now formatting our prices as normal, sorry, with a comma. And then these ones don't have any prices on them. Let me go and change. Let me see. Buy this cry later. Let me look for that property. Buy this cry later. Let's put a price of like 340,000. Then save this. Then which other property? There is deal or no deal. Let me make that $1,000. So deal or no deal here. Give it time to load up. Then deal or no deal here. Let's say the price here. The price is going to be $1,000. Then save this. Good. So if you go back to our client, refresh the page. Now the prices are going to show and it's formatted correctly. Then now if you want to go to a detail page, we haven't created the detail page yet. So if I click on get more info, yes, it redirects properly to the slug as we had declared before. But now the page is 404. Let's see if it works for all of them. This get info, it's the same 404. We've not done that yet. And that is the same 404. So good. But the routing, as you see, the routing is working to the correct slug. So what you can do is go back and make a git commit. So in a git client here, let's see, you can just say feature. Whoa, this is a feature on the client. And let's say it's add property component. Then make that commit. And then next, let's manage the changes to our React application pages. That's the head and the meta tags. Look at our current React application here. You see the head just remains as real estate. If you look at the top there. So we want to change this to, want this header of the document to change with respect to the page that you're navigating to. So we're going to add a package to help us with this. The package is called Helmet. So go back to your terminal. The containers running, let's bring them down. So you can say make down. Then let's navigate to the client directory. So cd into client. Then you're going to run npm install React Helmet. Good. And since we've added a new package, you have to build our containers, because remember, packages are installed at build time and not runtime. So you can say make, wow, navigate out of the client directory first. I was about to make the mistake again. Then say make build. Wow. Make build like that. So with the containers built, let's go back to our browser and see if everything still works. Good. We have no error messages. The page reloaded. So next, in the client components directory, let's create a title.jsx file. We're going to create a component for this, for Helmet. So what you can do here in, let's say, client src components here, create a new file. So we're going to call this, let's just call it title.jsx, like that. Then create a function component. Then you're going to bring in Helmet. So you can say import Helmet from React Helmet. Then we're going to say title is going to take in some props. So we're going to pass in the props of title like that. Then you're going to put in the description and the keywords. So if you go back to, let me show you something. If you go back to public index.html, what Helmet is basically going to help us do is change this title, the description, and any of these meta tags, should you wish to change this upon any different page reloading. So that's what we're trying to do here. So title, description, and keywords. We can say return the Helmet, say return Helmet, like that. And then we can see now for the title tag, we're going to pass in title. I'm going to pass in title like that. And then for the meta tag, so it's going to be a self-closing tag. So for meta, name is description. And then the content, we want to pass in as a prop, description. Is that spelling correct? Then you're going to have another meta tag. Now this is for the keywords. So content, pass in any keywords there. That's it. Then now for this if you don't pass in this title component, we want to have some default props. So you can see here title that default props here. So for the default properties, for the default properties, if this is not passed for the title, we want this to say welcome to real estate. As you see now, for default, it's just saying real estate up there. Then next, we're going to say description. The description is going to say we sell the best properties in town. Then any keywords. So for keywords here, let's just put maybe land. Land, then real estate, and then best value. Then save this component. Now we're going to add it to the homepage. So if you go back to pages, let me just close all this. If you go back to pages, then the homepage here, let's bring in now this title tag. So just above the header here, we're going to bring in the component title. Or isn't it auto importing? Let me see. Title like that. Oh, wait a minute. Components, title, imported. Okay, let me just bring it in. It's refusing to auto import. So I can say just import title from --- components title, like that. So we're going to pass in that there. Then save it. That's if you don't want to customize this, it's going to use the default props as you've declared here for the homepage. And then for the properties page here, we want to change something. So go back to pages here. On the properties page, we're still going to bring the same. So let me just go to homepage, copy this, go to properties page, add it in, import title from, yes, components title. And then in the properties page, let's go to the return block here. After the fragment, here you can just say title. Close it. But for this page, you want to pass in a prop, a value for a title prop. So here we're going to say our properties catalog, like that. Then you save this. Now, if you go back to application, as you can see, the properties page is loading and now the title has changed to our properties catalog. Let's go back to the homepage and see if it changes. Good. Homepage is now welcome to real estate properties or properties catalog. Homepage, welcome to real estate. So with that done, let's commit our code. You can go back to our Git client here and we can say feature, let's say add custom title component with helmet, then make that commit. So that was it for this section. See you in the next section. Cheers.